Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and hope you're having a good week so far. We're back with some latest space updates for you. Starting with Starship, we'll move on to discuss the new crew assigned by NASA for their Crew 4 mission. We'll end today's space updates with the Russian ASAT test and its consequences. Before we dig into the details, we're excited to let you know that we've launched our new channel, Defense Today, to cater your latest updates about US defense programs and some global movements as well. Check the link description below to give it a look and please subscribe. Let's start with some interesting Starship updates, where Starship Launch debut officially slips to 2022, and Musk is scheduled to give an official update on Starship soon. Now Starship orbital flight becomes officially destined for 2022. Recently, some reports have come up which state that the Federal Aviation Administration will complete the environmental review by the end of the year. According to the documentation of the US government, the regulatory agency would finish the environmental review of the Starship as well as Starbase within the 31st of December 2021. With this, it becomes fully clear that orbital Starship launch will not happen in 2021. Now, on the other hand, some recent reports state that Elon Musk will soon come up with an official update on next-gen Starship. This sort of an update had come earlier in September 2020. Regarding the recent Starship update, Musk will talk about Starship in the National Academies meeting. This program, titled SpaceX Starship Discussion, will take place virtually at National Academics' first virtual Space Studies Board. Christian Davenport, a space reporter, had tweeted, "The FAA expects to conclude its environmental assessment by December 31, 2021 for the SpaceX Starship Super Heavy Launch Vehicle Program at the SpaceX Boca Chica Launch Site in Cameron County, Texas. Permitting Board." Musk had appreciated the FAA's work in a reply tweet. He wrote, "The hard work by FAA, U.S. Fish and Wildlife, and Texas Parks and Wildlife is much appreciated, as well as the strong local support from Cameron County and Brownsville/South Padre. Report says that the FAA had taken a long time until September 2021 for publishing the draft of that environmental assessment. Thus, following that prolonged procedure, a good amount of delay till the end of the year has come up. According to some recent updates, the regulatory agency stated in an official email that their final environmental assessment, slated to publish at the end of the year, would include a finding of no significant impact or decision to initiate an environmental impact statement. Now, that internal estimate of publishing final environmental assessment by the 31st of December relies on the optimistic assumption that the FAA will rule in SpaceX's favor on the matter and issue a finding of no significant impact, or FONSI. It's unclear if that FONSI includes the possibility of a mitigated FONSI. If the FAA goes in for an environmental impact statement, then there are chances of restarting the environmental review process from the beginning. As a result, it may potentially delay the orbital Starship launches by a year or more time. Report says that there's also a good possibility that the permitting dashboard's claim of FAA's publishing of Starship final orbital environmental assessment, as well as processing of the assessment, could be done on the same day in quick succession, which, if happens, would be quite in favor of SpaceX. As for present goals, the 31st of December is the targeted date for FAA to issue a finding of no significant impact or mitigated FONSI before the end of 2021. But as we see, an extremely positive environmental review of Starship from the FAA will only complete a part of the larger process of securing an orbital Starship launch license. To get the launch license, even for a single Starship flight, it'll take a good deal of time. As for now, if the FAA really succeeds in publishing the final assessment by the 31st, then it'll be a good progress for them. We know that SpaceX has already completed their first successful six-engine Starship static fire, And it seems that SpaceX teams could potentially be technically ready for the first orbital Starship launch as soon as the ship's Super Heavy booster successfully completes those tests, which Ship 20 has carried out. Our next update is based on Jessica Watkins, whom NASA assigns as crew for SpaceX Crew 4 mission. Crew 2 has successfully returned. Crew 3 has successfully launched and docked with the International Space Station. Now, NASA focuses on their fourth mission of Commercial Crew Program, Crew 4. As per reports, Crew 4 is scheduled to launch in April 2022 aboard a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket from the launch pad of Launch Complex 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Just as the other crew missions for NASA, Crew 4 astronauts will also have a 6-month stay in the orbiting laboratory to carry out several science missions in microgravity. As for astronaut selection of the Crew 4 mission, NASA recently assigned Jessica Watkins as a crew for NASA's mission. Watkins will work as a mission specialist in the Crew 4 mission. Earlier this year, NASA had selected Kel Lindgren and Robert Hines as the commander and pilot of the Crew 4 mission. The agency had also selected European Space Agency astronaut Samantha Cristoforetti as a mission specialist for the Crew 4 mission. Now, Jessica Watkins joins them as a mission specialist, completing the full crew setup for the mission. As per reports, this mission will be the first space trip for Watkins since her selection as an astronaut in 2017. Watkins was born in Gaithersburg, Maryland, and considers Lafayette, Colorado her hometown. She'd received her bachelor's degree in geological and environmental sciences from Stanford University. She'd also completed her doctorate in geology from the University of California, Los Angeles. She'd carried out her graduate research on the emplacement mechanisms of large landslides on Mars and Earth. As per reports, she'd started her career as an intern at NASA, and then she'd also worked at NASA's Ames Research Center in California and Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California. While she was selected as an astronaut, she was a postdoctoral researcher in the Division of Geological and Planetary Sciences at the California Institute of Technology. She had also collaborated as a member of the science team for the Curiosity rover. We'll wrap up today with an update on the destruction of satellites in Russia's ASAT test. Recently, during the test of a Russian anti-satellite device, a defunct Russian satellite has been destroyed in low Earth orbit, creating 1,000 pieces of debris posing threats to other nations. Ned Price, an official of the U.S. State Department, said, "The Russian Federation recklessly conducted a destructive satellite test of a direct ascent anti-satellite missile against one of its own satellites. The test has so far generated over 1,500 pieces of trackable orbital debris and hundreds of thousands of pieces of smaller orbital debris that now threaten the interests of all nations." Report says the defunct satellite which got destroyed was Cosmos 1408. The satellite was launched in 1982, weighed about 2,000 kilograms. Price later stated that the test will significantly increase the risk to astronauts and cosmonauts on the International Space Station, as well as to other human spaceflight activities. On the 15th of November, the 7 people of the International Space Station were instructed to take shelter in their Crew Dragon and Soyuz vehicles because of a debris cloud. That crew was inside the spacecraft for nearly 2 hours. Though the debris cloud has made several close approaches to the space station, luckily no damage was reported. Just a few hours after the Russian ASAT test was confirmed, NASA later stated that it was the debris from that Russian test event that required the crew to shelter earlier in the day. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson stated, "Like Secretary Blinken, I'm outraged by this irresponsible and destabilizing action. With its long and storied history in human spaceflight, it's unthinkable that Russia would endanger not only the American and international partner astronauts of the ISS, but also their own cosmonauts." Nelson also pointed out that this event also poses a potential threat to China's space station. Price stated, "Russia's dangerous and irresponsible behavior jeopardizes the long-term sustainability of outer space and clearly demonstrates that Russia's claims of opposing the weaponization of space are disingenuous and hypocritical. General James Dickinson, commander of U.S. Space Command, said, "Russia has demonstrated a deliberate disregard for the security, safety, stability, and long-term sustainability of the space domain for all nations. Russia's tests of direct ascent anti-satellite weapons clearly demonstrate that Russia continues to pursue counter-space weapons systems that undermine strategic stability and pose a threat to all nations." The British government also criticized this test. Ben Wallace, Defense Secretary of the United Kingdom, said, "This destructive anti-satellite test by Russia shows a complete disregard for the security, safety, and sustainability of space. The debris resulting from this test will remain in orbit, putting satellites and human spaceflight at risk for years to come." That's all for today, and oh yes, please don't forget to visit our new channel, Defense Today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.